Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Let's Play FB Games with episode 12 of my WWE 2K16 My Career mode. Let me just sort the camera a tiny bit, there we are. But yeah, we have got another episode of My Career mode today. If you didn't see the last episode, we, I actually can't remember what we did, I'm going to be straight up honest. I think we lost to Kevin Owens, was it? I think we lost to Kevin Owens in the last episode. But yeah, we've got... Well, we're still at rank 6 in the rankings. We haven't gone down from that loss. Aiden English has fucking dropped massively. Hideo Itami's gone up. Sami Zayn and Kalisto have gone back down. And Kevin Owens is number 1 contender again. But that's not the point. The point is we've got a match against our rival just weeks... Well, actually, just days before the NXT Arrival pay-per-view. This is going to be quite a long episode because I'm going to fit in the NXT match and the Superstars match in on this episode if I have a Superstars match. So then the NXT Arrival match can have a video of its own. So we're going to head into this match here. Let's see the card. We've got Rusev versus Baron Corbin, Superstar versus Sami Zayn, Bo Dallas versus Fandango, Tyler Breeze versus Cammy, Adam Rose versus Jack Swagger, Neville versus Finn Balor, and Hideo Itami versus Kevin Owens. So let's get into this now. We're going to be facing off against Tyler Breeze just days before our pay-per-view match. I believe it'll be up if you match against Tyler Breeze as well. We load up the match. Where is Cammy? Oh, here he is. Oh, Cammy and Breeze are broad on the outside here. Hot diggity damn, I didn't expect that to happen. Tyler Breeze, the Russian leg sweep here. Cammy reversing. And now look at that pump handle slam, Tyler Breeze reversing it. And now Cammy reversing Breeze on the outside. It looks like he could go to another double count out here. 6 count, I swear it skipped 5. I may be wrong. But Cammy is just powering down Breeze here. I don't think Cammy cares about the referee's count here. I think he just wants to hurt Tyler Breeze, and he did. And there's another draw here between Tyler Breeze and Cammy. This match hasn't solved anything. Disappointing. Try to tell a story here, game. But yeah, anyway, another draw there. Probably going to interview us, probably asking us why we attacked Tyler Breeze. There you go. Another draw between Cammy and Tyler Breeze just days before the pay-per-view. This is going to be interesting to see the match at NXT Arrival. And we're not going to get an interview, which is surprising, considering it's days before the pay-per-view. So another draw there between Cammy and Tyler Breeze. That's interesting. Similar to the next event. So let's look at the results. Rusev beat Baron Corbin. Sami Zayn beat Superstar. Fandango beat Bo Dallas. Jack Swagger beat Adam Rose. Finn Balor beat Neville. And Kevin Owens beat Hideo Itami. So we got to Superstars here. Do we have a match on Superstars? We do. We're facing off against Hideo. Hideo Itami here. This could be interesting. Has Tyler Breeze got a match? No, Tyler Breeze never seems to be on Superstars, which is kind of weird. But anyway, the Superstars card is Jack Swagger versus Fandango. The Superstar versus Rusev, Adam Rose versus Bo Dallas, Kami versus Hideo Itami, a little bit of a rhyme there, Baron Corbin versus Stardust, Neville versus Sami Zayn, and Finn Balor versus Kevin Owens. Before we go in though, guys, we're still at rank 6, I think. I want to check if the, obviously the rankings have changed at all. Gotch has gone above us, Itami's gone below us. That's the only thing that seems to have changed. Let's look at the rankings for the rest of the titles. Still the same, I think. Yeah, basically still the same. But anyway, we've got Hideo Itami in a match tonight. This could be an incredible match. Jack Swagger beat Fandango. Rusev beat the Superstar. I didn't see the Adam Rose result. So, let's get into it. I was going to do NXT and Superstars the whole time in this episode, but I didn't think it would go as quickly. I thought it would be an actual match between Tyler Breeze and Kami, but they just wanted to fight on the outside, so it did. I'm going to take a quick drink while that loads up. Excuse the squeaky chair. Making sure I put the volume up. I couldn't remember if I did or not. Live here in New York.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making its way to the ring from parts unknown. Dynamite!
This guy will settle for nothing short of a victory here tonight. Whoa, it looks like he hasn't missed many gym sessions.
And Kami will be looking for a big win here on Superstars, just 2 days before our NXT arrival. This will be Kami's NXT pay-per-view debut. So obviously he'll be looking to get the victory. Kami with the adoring WWE Universe in the background. The WWE Universe seem to have taken a liking to Kami straight from the off. And that's good for a WWE superstar. And Kami and Tyler Breeze have had a physical rivalry that's escalated over the past few weeks. It's scheduled to come to a head at NXT Arrival. Whether it actually will or not is unknown. But let's get Hideo Itami out here. Let's fight this man. Let's try and pick up some momentum before NXT arrival. Hideo. I really like Hideo Itami, if I'm straight up honest. Now, Hideo Itami, I'm not sure if he has a match at NXT Arrival, but he has had some confrontations against NXT champion Finn Balor and number one contender Kevin Owens. So that means he might be in that mix. But he is number 7 in the rankings. He's just one below us. So I could be wrong completely there. Kami just there in the background. And Itami points up to the sky. And both these guys, fan favourites here in New York City. Only one of them, of course, will come out on top. Will it be Kami? Or will it be Itami? We'll find out as this match gets underway here on Superstars. Test your strength to open the match up here. Kami back in Itami into the corner. Referee asking for a clean break. And Kami and Hideo respect each other enough for a clean break. Going for another one. And they're going into the corner again. Referee asking for another clean break. And Itami with a punch there. Maybe looking to rile up Kami here. Another test of strength here. And this time Itami wins it. Wrench in the arm is Itami. Kami reversing it. He's got Itami's arm locked now. And now Russian legs, well, I guess an STO there by Kami. No, another test of strength. Now Itami backing Kami into the corner here. Referee asking for a clean break. And this time Kami returning the favour here with a strike. Itami did it last time, Kami doing it this time. And now another test of strength. Today Itami winning it out again, but Kami seems to be able to fight out of these with not much issue. Although Itami now with a headlock. Grounding Kami here. And knee to the back. And Kami's been on a recent losing streak from what I can remember. Oh no, it wasn't a superstar. It wasn't Kevin Owens last episode. It was Simon Gotch and... No, it was Simon Gotch and Kevin Owens. No, it wasn't. I can't remember exactly what was last episode. I think it was we faced Simon Gotch and then we watched Tyler Breeze's match against Kevin Owens. No, that was... Okay, guys, now I remember what it was now. It was the Kevin Owens Superstars match last episode, and the episode before it was Gotch and that. That's what it was. Hideo Itami dragging Kami into the middle now as I try and regain my memory. Stepping on Kami here and a kick now by Itami. This is not good here for Kami just days before NXT arrival and his clash with Tyler Breeze. Kami looking for a ground move now on Itami. He breaks out with a jawbreaker. Kami throwing Itami off the ropes. Itami fighting back with a punch, and now I'm out of reversals, which means this could be a problem. German suplex by Itami. It could be over early here for Kami. And Itami with a cover. I didn't want to risk it, guys. I was going to go for a two count there, but I didn't want to risk it. Anyway, knee to the back now by Itami. Kami just lifting his way out of that move there. Of course, Itami reversing again. But now neither of us have no reversal stocks left. So whoever gets control now basically has control of the match. Belly to belly by Kami here. And now he could be looking for that powerbomb that we've seen him use loads of times. Not the sit-out powerbomb, just a regular powerbomb that still does a lot of damage. And now Kami slamming Itami down. Itami fighting out there, jawbreaker. Uppercut by Kami, Itami did see it coming. And another slam. Elbow drop by Kami. And Kami getting this NXT crowd here at New York City fired up. And what's he doing here? Flipping Itami over like a pancake. Kami needs a good performance here. Just days before NXT arrival. If he wants to prove himself as a threat to Breeze. He hasn't been able to so far. Mainly because he's lost his last two matches. So he'll need to turn his performance around here. And it looks like he will be doing, because he's going for that pump handle side slam on Itami. And that sometimes can end the match here. Cover by Kami. And a kick out at the last second from Hideo. 2.5. Kami thought he had that then. Turns out he didn't. And now, hooking the arms, German suplex. And now knee to the head. I don't know what Kami's trying to target here, but I think he's just trying to target anybody part of Itami that will weaken him. Well, will weaken Itami as well as weaken Itami's chances of hitting big moves, such as the GTS, which could come out of anywhere at any time. And now Kami's working on Itami's head here, although Itami has fought out here. And the last thing Kami needs here is a loss. But it looks like it could be a loss in Kami's future. Once again, the punches and now the kicks by Itami. And that may be all that she wrote here. No, the last second. That was unintentional. That was completely unintentional. I tried to kick out the first possible opportunity. But the game said no. And the time is now. GTS. And Cammy somehow kicking out of the GTS. How has Cammy fought out here? And Tammy looking to come back now. But Cammy looking to make sure it doesn't happen. And now in the middle of the ring. The slam once again. And now Cammy just punches now. Very aggressive moves here. And the fans here in New York City loving it. Off the ropes now goes Cammy. Itami with the comeback. I definitely hit that first. I can guarantee you I hit that first. But anyway, Itami may have this in hand here. Hideo may look to finish off Cammy here once again with the kicks. And the slaps and the forearms and the chops and everything that Itami does. Looking to finish off Cammy here. And somehow Cammy kicks out. Tammy, I don't know what he was looking for there, but Cammy's far out of it. And it could be Cammy's chance to take advantage here. Under the legs, of course. And now, pump handle side slam. And not only that, Cammy looking to apply the finishing touches here on Hideo Itami. He's caught him. Sit out powerbomb. That should do it here. In New York City. Making sure he can't go towards the ropes here. Hideo Itami kicks out. How has Hideo Itami fought out of that? What an incredible match we've got here, ladies and gentlemen. How has Hideo Itami fought out of that? And Hideo, he's got Cammy down. Cammy refusing to give up though. Using his strength to fight out. Continuing the punishment here. Although I think Hideo has fought out again. Into the corner now. Goes Cammy. And now Itami has got Cammy in deep trouble. This could be all that she wrote for this match. If Hideo Itami gets this off, he doesn't. Now clothesline. And it could be Cammy's night here on Superstars. What an incredible match we are bearing witness to just days before NXT arrival. Looks like Cammy's going second rope here. Splashing Itami there. Kicking out of it is Itami, quite literally kicking out. If he goes for a cover here, I'm going to be upset, especially if I get pinned. Hideo. And Cammy kicks out. You don't go for a cover just after you kick me off here, Itami. It's just not going to happen like that. Boot by Cammy now. Now just showing off for the crowd here in New York. Now under the legs once again, of course. Pump handle side slam. And you know what's coming now. What always comes after a pump handle side slam. Oh, I wonder. Is it possibly the sit-out powerbomb? 4.5-star match on Superstars. That's incredible. But that's got to be ball game, as JPL says. That's got to be it here. Hideo Itami can't kick out of this. If he kicks out, he's superhuman. And it is a 3 count. Kami and Hideo Itami put on a completely impressive match here as superstars, and it will be Kami who comes out victorious just days before NXT arrival. Unknown veteran, what? Win 10 times using a custom superstar. Okay. I thought it was like a superstars achievement where if I got 4.5-star match, that'd be like impressive. Although I think I got a 4.5-star match in that tag team match. You know, the very first tag team match I did where I was teaming with Baron Corbin and I was against Hideo Itami and Finn Balor. I think that was a 4.5-star match. I might be wrong on that, but I thought it was 4.5. Anyway, I can't exactly remember, but that was definitely a 4.5-star match. Undisputed 4.5-star match. That was incredible. But Kami comes out on top just days before NXT arrival. I've said that phrase so many times this episode, and I apologise. But NXT arrival is our NXT pay-per-view debut. Our pay-per-view debut in general. So I need to, you know, plug it, get it in there. And this was the finish. Kami delivering that sit-out powerbomb. I just realised something. There hasn't been any divas in this. I'm guessing that's because I'm... Well, I guess I could have them as managers. I guess that means that they don't actually participate. But anyway, Kami, with an impressive win. That was an incredible match. 4.5 stars. Instant classic. Oh my god, 4.5 stars. Our virtual currency's now got up to 10,000. Just 310,000 more guys and we can get Paul Heyman. It's going to be a long time till we get Paul Heyman. I don't know if we'll have an interview, so I'm going to keep the volume up in case we do. If we don't, then I'll turn it back down. There's still a lot of achievements on this game I haven't got yet. That's mainly because I've only been playing career mode, my career mode. And a bit of showcase. Well, showcase as well, obviously. Let's see what happens. Okay, we'd have an interview. Which is surprising considering we're literally at NXT arrival now. Your rank increased. Okay. So, Hideo Itami's gone down to 7th. Simon Gotch's gone up to 6th. We've got up to 5th in the rankings. A little bit further, we'll be challenging Finn Balor. That's incredible. Now, let's see what happened on the Superstars matches. Bo Dallas beat Adam Rose. Stardust beat Baron Corbin. Sami Zayn beat Neville. And Kevin Owens beat Finn Balor. Now, NXT arrival, guys. This is going to be our pay-per-view debut. Before we go, let's take a look at what the card will be. The main event is the NXT Championship match between Finn Balor and Kevin Owens. So it's going to be Sami Zayn versus Kalisto, Superstar versus Bo Dallas. The Vault Villains face off as Simon Gotch takes on Aiden English. We're going to have a match against Tyler Breeze. Hopefully we'll have a definite conclusion to it. Colin Cassidy versus Curtis Axel, Neville versus Jack Swagger, and the main event will be Finn Balor versus Kevin Owens, the NXT Championship. But that's not the match we're looking at. The match we're looking at is, of course, the Tyler Breeze versus Kami one, of course. Why can't we go to the... Oh, we have to do a main roster thing. I just remembered. So before we continue, we've got 10,000 virtual currency. We've got some abilities if we want to buy them with our superstar points. I have got resiliency, but I'm not good at it at the moment. I kind of don't want to have any abilities until I get out of NXT, or at least till I get a title match. I think what I'm going to do is when I'm starting to chase the NXT title, I'll start getting abilities. I'll put my resiliency ability in once I do that, once I go for the NXT Championship. But before then, I'm going to keep it out of play. So we've got a match against Tyler Breeze, NXT arrival, coming up next in the next episode. What a match we had against Hideo Itami, though. But I'm going to stop talking now, guys. I'm going to leave you to get on with your day. I hope you guys have enjoyed episode 12 here. I hope you guys enjoy watching the classic that is Hideo Itami versus Kami. And up next, we will make our NXT pay-per-view debut. But that's it for now, and I'll see you next time for episode 13.